Let's get right to it. Most machine learning is two things. It's data sourcing and it's data cleansing. Data sourcing means you gather the correct data for your problem. Around 80% of real-world machine learning is structured data. That means you're going to need to author the SQL to source your data and then import a few thousand rows into your notebook to clean it. Once you're done cleaning in your notebook, you need to move that data to a location that can be cleansed at scale. You can't cleanse 200 million rows on your laptop. Not how the real world works. All right, let's focus on data cleansing in this video. All computers are monolingual. They speak numbers, and that's it. It's your job to numerize the data to help your model do its job in finding patterns. I don't think numerize is a word, but I like it there. All machine learning is finding patterns. Here's a nice clinical definition I found of data cleansing. Data cleansing, which is also referred to as data cleaning and data scrubbing, and sometimes data wrangling, is the process of fixing incorrect, incomplete, duplicate, or otherwise erroneous data in your dataset. It involves identifying data errors and then changing them, updating or removing data to correct them. Let's check out the famous Titanic dataset. It's already been sourced for you, so all we need to do is clean it. Before you can move forward with the data cleansing process, you're going to need to know exactly what every attribute means. The first step in cleansing the dataset is removing unnecessary features. Now notice I'm calling them features and attributes, because that's the machine learning terminology. In the world of databases, these are columns. You'll need to learn to speak both languages to work in those spaces. What's the first thing you notice? How about the passenger ID on the left-hand side? It appears to be a sequentially assigned number. How would a sequentially assigned number help you find patterns? Right, it wouldn't, so it's gone. All right, that was easy. Moving on, what jumps out next? How about the person's name? Names are mostly unique. Again, same thought process. How does a name help your model find patterns? It doesn't, it's gone. Okay, now it gets a little harder. Now we need a complete understanding of the attributes. I know that ticket is a randomly assigned number, so I remove that feature also. Okay, so you know what the process looks like now. The only way to learn data cleansing is to take a class on how to cleanse data. That's it. It's the most important machine learning course in my library. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and have a great day. We'll see you soon.